Analysis of data by Operation Black Vote and The Guardian newspaper shows that barely 3% of Britain's most powerful and influential people are from black and minority ethnic groups. 13% of the wider population are from BAME backgrounds. So why the huge difference? Let's talk to Simon Woolley, director and one of the founders of Operation Black Vote, which helped compile the colour of power data. And in Derby, we've got Hardil Dinser. He's the police and crime commissioner for Derbyshire. And he's the first and only person to hold such a role from a BAME background. Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Tell us a little bit more about the research you did, Simon.
Yes. Well, we think it's groundbreaking research. It's never been done before. I want to thank our partners, GreenPark Recruitment and The Guardian, for making this process and this research. Look, I think we have the opportunity to have a potentially fantastic debate about who wields power and what does it mean for us. At the moment, pathways to power for black and minority ethnic communities are almost non-existent. And that's a waste of talent. You know, right now in a post-Brexit world, we need all the talent we can muster to turbocharge Britain PLC.
And when you say pathways to power, specifically, what are you talking about?
Well, I guess some significant pathways. First, education. The route to power is vital through education. And when you consider there are five public schools that account for 50% of the intake of Oxford and Cambridge, as opposed to 1,800, you can see that class and privilege rank high. Secondly, of course, then, that you see government and you see how that's disproportionately white. They make our key decisions. We need more diversity in there. And then, of course, when you're going for jobs, David Cameron himself said that it's a national scandal that a black woman has to change her name from an African name or an Asian name just to get an interview.
Yeah. Hardil, thank you for talking to us. In terms of your reaction to the fact that 3% of 97% of the most powerful people in British society are white, how do you react?
Well, it's not surprising. It's something that I'm aware of. I'm pleased to be in that small minority, but the work I'm doing as the first BME Police and Crime Commissioner in policing in England and Wales is to really work on how policing can have more better representation of diverse communities that they police and represent.
And how are you doing that? What practical measures are you bringing in to change things?
Well, one of the things we're doing is that we're trying to pursue the Peelian principle of the public are the police and the police are the public, which means that if you want to have confidence, cooperation and support of the public in terms of helping policing to be carried out, you need to reflect those communities. So all across the country, there's no single police force which represents their population in their workforce, and there's a challenge which has been put out to police and crime commissioners across the country to proactively work with their chief constables to close that gap. In Derbyshire, there's 3.4% of our workforce is BME, where 6.7%, according to the 2011 census, is the population diversity in our in Derbyshire. Okay. So I'm working with the chief constable through positive action to see how we can actually close that gap and actually see how we can increase the confidence of people from BME communities to think that they can have a career in policing, but also increase the confidence of people in the force to actually recruit BME communities.
Final thought, if you did this research again in 10 years, do you think the figures will be that different?
Let's hope there's a change. We have to have the conversation first, open up the pathways, and if we do, everybody benefits. We believe that in every street, in every city, in every corner of the country, there lies potential talent. We need to unleash it. We need to have the framework so people can excel and fulfil their ambition. Everybody benefits. Black and white, business, Britain PLC is turbocharged.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much for coming on the programme. On the programme tomorrow, who are Generation Z? They've grown up only knowing the internet and war on terror, but what else makes them tick? Join us tomorrow. Have a good day. Thanks for watching.